Philippine senators have started filing their respective priority bills ahead of the formal opening of the 19th Congress. Among them is Senator Sonny Angara. He now joins us live to give us a deeper look at his priority measures. Good afternoon, Senator. Thank you for joining us.
Good afternoon, Ron, and good afternoon to the viewers.
Nice to talk to you again, sir. Now, we've seen the bills you filed for the incoming Congress, and some of them are under the title Tatak Pinoy. Can you tell us what Tatak Pinoy is and why it's a priority for you?
Well, Tatak Pinoy, translated, I guess, is made in the Philippines or Philippine-made. So it's a drive or advocacy to promote Philippine products and to make sure we up our game in terms of the sophistication of the products we create, their competitiveness, and their complexity. Complexity meaning there's more value added to these products. No? So we filed some bills to spur exports by removing red tape, a lot of the friction costs associated, and for the Philippines to hopefully expand its product offerings. Because if you look at in Southeast Asia, I think we're sixth in terms of exports. So, and we create or produce around 2,700 product offerings, something like that, compared to maybe 4,000 for a country like Vietnam or Indonesia. So, these countries are used to making things, whereas we're very good at what we do, but we can also be better, I think. Because if you look at the economy now, there's a lot of low-paying jobs. So one way of creating better-paying jobs is to create a better or more robust domestic economy.
Go ahead, sir.
Yes. We also have a bill which is the domestic certification. So it's a preference for local bidders as long as the prices they offer in procurement by government is within a certain band that is acceptable. No? That's also within the realm of the Procurement Act. But it needs a certification for a domestic manufacturer. So that's something that will help spur, hopefully, because the government is now a very big procurer of goods and services. No? So that would help a lot of our small and medium enterprises.
One of the bills under Tatak Pinoy is the Tatak Pinoy Finance Resolution. Can you tell us more about that?
Well, that's more of a trying to take a holistic view because Tatak Pinoy cross-cuts trade and industry, agriculture, tourism, ICT, information technology. So there's no one really overseeing the whole effort of Philippine offerings falling within these different industries and areas of endeavor. No? So, Ron, I think this is just something to kind of spur multi-agency effort to push Philippine products and services around the globe.
Or maybe one agency looking after that?
There's no agency at the moment. No? So I think the Senate as a policymaking body could help the agencies and help the stakeholders in terms of knowing what's lacking and how mm-hmm. how to level up in terms of whether it's packaging, marketing, access to markets, financing, etc. All of these logistics, all of these things which go into making a very competitive product.
Okay, one of the other bills this time could get public school teachers excited. It's the bill raising the minimum salary grade. We do know that you filed this before. I think it was 2019, if I'm not mistaken. Can you tell us what happened then?
Actually, Ron, I've been filing this bill since I was a congressman back in 2004. Okay. But we get the same answer always from the government, which is, or from the executive, we're all part of the government, from the executive branch or the DBM, which tries to rationalize the bureaucracy. Basically, they're not in favor of an approach which targets the teachers individually. No, they want a salary raise across the board. That's why we have most recently salary standardization or salary raising. I think it's package 5 or 6, which we sponsored a few years back. So we still live in hope that the teachers would be given preferential treatment as they are in countries like Finland, Singapore, where they're fairly well paid compared to other occupations.
Are you more optimistic of passing this time, most especially since it jibes with the priorities and the advocacy of the president and the vice president?
Well, hope springs eternal, Ron. No, but of course, our finances now is not perhaps the healthiest in terms of fiscal space, no, around the globe. A lot of countries are tightening their belts, and we're no exception. So we're still hoping, but maybe not this year, but perhaps in the coming years when the economy improves.
But in this bill, how much an increase would the teachers see in their paychecks if it is?
It's a salary grade 11 to 18, so I think that's at least a 20 or 30,000 peso increase, if I'm not mistaken, for a month.
Okay, so we'll share in your hopes of that being passed for this Congress as well. And talking about the incoming Senate, and any expectations and possibly challenges facing the 19th Congress, Senate in the 19th Congress?
Well, it's a new Congress. There's new faces and there's returning faces, mm-hmm. Ron. No? So a lot of veteran legislators as well returning. So I think there's a new administration, a new president, a new vice president. So I think given their strong majority, the congressmen and senators are also looking forward to support the legislative agenda of the president and his agencies, especially given the current situation of the country and our countrymen, you know, with rising prices, an economy that that we hoped was recovering already after the pandemic, but because of COVID, because of other factors like the Ukraine war, the Russia-Ukraine war, we're suffering prolonged there's a prolonged suffering because of the rising prices. So hopefully we can address that somehow in the legislature.
And with that strong majority that you mentioned, do you think that the Senate can maintain its integrity and independence, most especially under Senate President Zubiri, who ran under the party of President Marcos?
Yes, I'm quite confident of that, having spent 9 years in the Senate, Ron. I see how senators interact with each other. There's always a certain desire to rise above the partisan nature of politics and to kind of push for a higher national interest. So, and in the Senate, you have different political persuasions, different political parties. So it's challenging, but I've seen it happen that during the pandemic, especially when the legislature really worked very closely with the executive to come up with very big stimulus packages like Bayanihan 1, Bayanihan 2, mm-hmm. the vaccination app, among others. No?
Senator Sonny Angara, thank you very much for talking to us.
Thanks very much for having me, Ron.